Okay, welcome to find the interval convergence of this power series by using the ratio test. So here is our an, right? And let me write this down right here. We will be using the ratio test. And by the ratio test, we will have to first take the limit as n goes to infinity. And now let's look at the absolute value of an plus 1 times 1 over an. Okay, so plugging n plus 1 into all these n's here, we will have parentheses n plus 1 and then square. And then this is going to give us x plus 2 to the n plus 1 power over 2 to the n plus 1 power, like this, right? And we multiply by the reciprocal of the original. This will go on the top, 2 to the n over this, and that will go to the denominator, n squared times x plus 2 to the n, like that, inside of the absolute value. So this is the usual deal. And now, let me just keep this part as how it is, n plus 1 squared. But for this, I can write it down as x plus 2 to the n times x plus 2 to the first. And this is the same as 2 to the n times 2 to the first. And let's do some cancellations. This right here, cancel out with that. And 2 to the n, cancel each other out as well. Okay, so the usual business, right? So next, we will have the absolute value. And as I said, I'll just keep this right here, right? And this is the only thing that has the n on the top now. So we have n plus 1 square over, we have a 2 on the bottom, and we have n squared on the bottom like this, right? And also we have the x plus 2 on the side like this, okay? And that's what we have. And next, what do? We take the limit, isn't it? Okay, so the limit, for n goes to infinity, on the top, this is n plus 1 squared, and you know this is the same as n squared plus 2n plus 1. And you look at the dominating part, which is n squared. That's the term that has the highest power of x, well, n in this case. And look at the bottom, which is just 2 times n squared. So altogether, this is going to be approaching to 1 half, right? So it's approaching, so we draw the arrow. All this is going to be approaching to 1 half. And we still have the absolute value. And then we put down the x plus 2 inside, right? Now, this is the result of the limit when n goes to infinity. We have to make sure that this right here to be less than 1, right? And then just continue and do the usual business. Multiply by 2 on both sides, so we can say absolute value of x plus 2, which is less than 2 now. From here, what do we know? This is going to be the radius. And this, you see, we have the absolute value of x minus negative 2, right? So this right here, we know that the center is actually at negative 2, because you have to look at this as x minus something. In this case, it's x minus negative 2. Okay, right here, I can draw you guys a number line. The center is at negative 2, so let me just indicate here is my negative 2. Radius of convergence is 2. That means I can go from the center to the left twice, and I'll end up with negative 4. And then I'll go from the center to the right 2 times, and that will be 0. Well, I don't know what will happen at the endpoints, so let me just put down this kind of things for you guys. That's my special interval notation, because I don't know. Should I include it or not, right? And now, the deal is that we have to do the check, right? So here we go. Let's go ahead and check negative 4. When x is equal to negative 4, what will happen to our series? Plugging negative 4 into this x, we will end up with the series when n goes from 0 to infinity, n squared over 2 to the n, and then parentheses, the x is the negative 4. So put that right here, and then we add a 2 to that, and then raise to the n's power. And we continue. This is going to give us the series when n goes from 0 to infinity. This is just n squared over 2 to the n. And you know this right here, it's going to be negative 2 inside, and then raised to the n's power. So I can write this down as negative 1 to the n's power, and then 2 to the nth power, right? Once again, negative 2 and then to the nth power, I can look at that as negative 1 to the nth power times 2 to the nth power. And the reason I want to do that is because I see that 2 to the n, 2 to the n cancel each other out. And this is just going to be the series when n goes from 0 to infinity. This is negative 1 to the nth power. I just want to put this down first. And then we multiply by n squared. This n squared is not in the denominator. This is just, you know, like this. Okay, does this converge or not? Well, yes, it's alternating, but this one does not converge because this guy doesn't even go to 0, right? So let me just make a note right here. As n goes to infinity, this guy, right, which is negative 1 to the n times n squared, this right here doesn't even go to 0, right? Because you can imagine when n is infinity right here, infinity squared, you are just going to be jumping up and down, but it doesn't really matter. You just have to indicate that this inside doesn't go to 0. Okay, this right here diverges. And I'll tell you, this right here diverges at x equals to negative 4. And the reason that this diverges is because you can say when you do the limit, if this right here doesn't approach 0, you can conclude that it diverges. And to quote a test for that, that's the test for divergence, all right? Test for divergence. You're just checking the limit of this expression. If it does not go to 0, that's it. This series diverges. So that's pretty much it. Okay, we'll come here. At negative 4, it diverges. So I can tell you, let's put down a parenthesis. We are not going to include negative 4. Okay, do the same thing with the other endpoint. Let's go ahead and check. 0, when x is equal to 0, do the same thing, plugging 0 into here, and we will have the series when n goes from 0 to infinity, n squared over 2 to the n, 0 plus 2 inside, right? So 0 plus 2 inside and then to the nth power. And this is the same as series when n goes from 0 to infinity, n squared over 2 to the n, and this is just 2 to the n, right? And you know this and that cancel out right away. I should put this down in black. And this is going to give us the series when n goes from 0 to infinity. And this is just n squared. And you're adding up infinitely many squares. And this is going to be infinity for sure, right? Because once again, just make a note again. Let me just note. As n goes to infinity, this time we just have n squared. This doesn't go to 0 neither. This, of course, diverges, right? So I'll just tell you guys, this diverges at x equals to 0 as well. Once again, by test for divergence. So I don't want to include 0 neither, okay? And right here, I will tell you, the radius convergence is 2. And then the interval convergence is from negative 4 to 0. But do not include the negative 4, do not include the 0. And this right here will be the answer. That's it.